branches out to the two major wings of the mansion, the east wing and the west. There are two attics here, one on each side. But of course there are! Wait, wait. Jay, all you had to pay was $1.99. But the east one has been converted to a storage room of sorts, and somehow I find it at least likely for Rose to wander there by herself. Besides, she never did like going to stuffy storage rooms. So I head towards the west wing first, where a simple wooden door at the end of the hall opens to a small room. Oh! Wait a minute, it's $1.99 for shipping? Damn, that's actually really good, because my shipping on... I got an iPower PC pre-made way back when I was being lazy, didn't want to actually build my own. Shipping was $56 for the entire, like, tower and everything inside of it. So, $1.99, there you go. I would never do real estate, just, like, ever, Jamie, because of this. Inside is another set of steps leading to the second attic. Unlike the grand staircase, though, the stairs to the attic are steep and narrow, made of old stones and covered with a thick coating of dust that kicks up into the air with every step. Thank God, it's still daytime. Not nearly as spooky. If it isn't for the light streaming through the door behind me, I may easily stumble and fall. With how old the place is, there are no light fixtures to illuminate the cramped passage up. But you do have a cell phone. Now, they are normally pretty bright, so just saying. Why didn't they bother to add one here when they renovated it? Escapes me. Sheesh. They did it with the rest of the house. Small bedroom welcomes me at the end. Yeah, and I'm gonna save. It looks exactly as it did the last time I've been here. Full of dust, worn out, and faded by the time. She's not in here. Let's go to the other room. Odd, I thought they cleaned everything. Did the crew miss this room? Ugh. Cleanliness is the least of my concerns right now. The more pressing matter is Rose. She's not here. Was I dreaming when I talked to her a while ago? Did I mishear her? How do you jump to dreaming? No. It couldn't have been a dream. I mean, you were standing. You were awake. It's not like early morning. After all, the creepy ambience of this estate is doing such a remarkable job of making sure I stay alert and awake. And I'm sure she said she's here in the attic. Is this a prank? Or maybe the phone call... That phone call was Rose's last message to me before the curse got to her. See, all these thoughts are telling me, leave the house. Jimmy, you cheeky bastard. Oh. See, new egg. Good choice. I'd bring more than a thermal camera. I'd bring a proton pack. Shutting. Maybe she's under the bed. I would not look under the bed. I'm just gonna say, I would not look under the bed. Ugh, shut up, brain. You're not helping. Don't make this scarier than it already is. But if she's not here... Then where is she? The hell was that? That's it. I can't do this anymore. Alright, me and Isabella, spirit animals, kindred spirits, however you want to call it. Yep. I'm leaving. I'm out. Rose, you can deal with the ghost yourself. It's okay. You must have angered the spirits living here. I knew disturbing this mansion was a bad idea right from the very start. Yeah, right. But nobody listened. Be realistic, they said. They think I'm cuckoo because I believe in curses and ghosts and all that. Me, my outlandish backwater country beliefs. I've always tried to be a model employee, but not this time. No, I'm noping out. Briar Realty can find another agent who's more realistic to tour people around this haunted house. Before leaving, I take one last look at the gloomy old room. Just to check.
Huh? What's this?
No! That's a trap! Why'd you have to do that? You didn't have to do that! My worries about Rose's whereabouts must have caused me to miss it when I first entered the room. There's clearly something on the floor. No! No, no, no. No, 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 no. It looks like...
A letter?
A letter? Lying on the ground just a couple of inches away from my feet. Out of sheer curiosity, I lean down and pick it up. I wouldn't. I'd walk out. I'd be like, oh, there's a letter on the ground. Nope. That's why I would live. Strange. We're near the bed. Damn it, Super. I don't recall seeing this the last time I was here. Why are you doing this? A few days back, me and a few other agents inspected the mansion to prepare for today.
Ooh! Ooh!
Mm. See, it's slipping right near the bed, dude. You know what's gonna happen. It's gonna grab my hand. Door's gonna slam. Thanks, Willow. And then we're gone. I'd have been the last to look inside the attic and leave, and this certainly hadn't been here before. It's the last will and testament of Rose. Person we don't know the last name to. Someone must have left it in this room since then. Did Rose leave this for me? Was she here a while ago? Was her last thing to do before she died is to look for pen and paper and jot a note down being like, the house is going to kill us! And or you. I mean, she could have just texted. Just technology, it's what it is. I can't have missed this. I can't have missed her, though, can I? There's only one set of stairs to and from the attic. The letter isn't exactly in pristine condition. In fact, it looks rather ancient. Now, yeah, don't touch it. Don't. You touched it, and now you're marked. I'm saying it. It's like the ring. Every time you go to watch the video, you're marked. Touch the letter, you're marked. Or read the letter, you're marked. The paper is so thin and rough, I'm worried it'll fall apart if I so much as touch it. Then don't touch it! She touched it! With great care, I open it, and what I read shakes me to my core, because... I don't know, do you want to die? Is that it? If you believe in superstition, why are you doing the thing that you're being superstitious? Yeah, there we go.
What? Oh my god.
Well, Rose only had one thing to say. Just a few dozen times. Nothing but the words help me fills the page, all of it seemingly written with a crimson shaded pen. It's called blood, lady. Or blood. See? I go. The same phrase just goes on and on until... Send this to 5 people or else... Are you shitting me? How is that scary? If you have an email account, you've gotten something like this before. If you don't send this to 15 or more people, they're going to die. It's like... You lost me, game. You lost me.
Send this to 5 people or else. Or else what?
You're gonna get spam mail. Yeah.
Or else what?
As quickly as I can, I scan the back of the paper and peek into the envelope to make sure I'm not missing out on a second page. But there's nothing.
No. Oh, please, no.
My hands tremble as dread creeps over me. I would be like, you know what, ghost? Suck it! And then I'd run out screaming. The room is suddenly getting colder. Why are you still in the room? I need to get out of here. Good girl. Folding the paper in half, the sight that greets me next has me frozen on the spot. Ooh. See, now we got a problem. See, what you do is you just... You don't look up, right? You inch back slowly, turn around, open the door, and then run. Yeah. Now make sure you don't have high heels, because if you're running with high heels, we know that that's usually a bad thing. A pair of blood-soaked feet enters my vision, field of vision, covered in gaping wounds with skin eaten away to reveal flesh, bone, and all manner of things one isn't meant to see. It's too much. Save. All of it is too much. I want to cry, call for help, but the words catch my throat. Even my feet won't move, completely paralyzed at a terror. Lord, please help me. Close eyes and pray. Shut my eyes tight, muttering fervent prayers under my breath.
Our Father, who art in heaven.
That's a bad idea.
Why would you close your eyes? You can pray with your eyes open, right?
It's a trap!
Yeah, it's a trap. Oh, boy. Prayers taught me as a child by my mama and my papa slip out endlessly through my teeth. Because God, oh God, if you have to listen to any of my prayers, please listen to this one. And if God doesn't listen, at least I won't see the thing that kills me. Cold comfort. I wait. And I wait some more. But when nothing happens, I dare to peek. No! Oh. If it wants me to spread its ghostly curse, it's gonna keep us alive. Right? It have to. If it gets us now, there's no point in what it wants. It's only denying itself the joy of 5 more people. Only to find that the ghost, the thing, whatever it is, gone. Relief washes over me as I shakily get up to my feet and back away towards the door. As she gets open, I slip out with a second thought, make a run for it, down the stairs and onto the hallway. Take a look back to make sure it wasn't behind. It isn't behind me. Why would you do that? Just run. There's a door. There's an entrance. Go. Any other person might have stopped, dismissed it as a trick of the light and an overactive imagination. But I'm not taking any chances. I'm not giving that thing another chance to catch me off guard. Just keep going. I don't think I'll ever feel safe until I get out of here. Okay, whatever that is, every warning bell in my mind is telling me that it's going to jump out at any moment and get me while I'm still in its place.
I told them! I freaking told them! Oh man, oh man, oh man!
Just say this outside the house. That way it's okay. See? There you go, Jamie. Jurassic World. Exactly. Racing down the stairs. A breathy laugh escapes me, and my shoe slips, and I find myself falling. You know what? I know it's fashion. I know it's fashion to have high heels, right? But if you're gonna go to a creepy place to do your job, wear flats. Or tennis shoes or boots. Something, right? Yeah. Till my back hits the ground and pain racks my body. My head grows fuzzy and my vision dims as I fight to stay conscious.
No.
It's gonna get us.
Go.
Which does make sense.
Away.
The last thing I see are those feet before all I know is darkness. I mean, that was a good song, and that was actually a good intro. I just, that, like, clocked me. I was not expecting that. A buzz breaks the silence. I start to rouse, pulled into consciousness against my own will. I've never felt this tired before. I just want to sleep, but the insistent buzzing, poking, and prodding isn't letting me. My old mattress may not be the comfiest of places, but that doesn't make me any more eager to wake up. Isabella?
5 more minutes, Becca.
You're on the ground bleeding. Token. Hey, I'm going to try to make him not the token black guy, okay? He's going to live, right? If I can. Also, he looked like a nice guy, right? I mean, you know. But yeah, like random anime intro, which it was done well, though. So that's great. I'm actually kind of curious to see if they have a full version of that song, too. I swat away what is nudging persistently at my side. Come on! Can I just get a few extra minutes of sleep today? I promise I'll work hard once I'm up. See, I keep telling myself that every morning, and every morning... It's... No. So my girlfriend had to roll me out of bed. Well, roll, I mean by shoving and me landing on the ground. So, a hand lightly taps my cheek and something cold is suddenly being pressed to the back of my head. As the sensation slowly spreads throughout the area, giving me an uncomfortable feeling. No, she's not alright. Yeah, go for it. Thanks, SJ.
Isabella? Yes, can you hear me?
Breaker. No, I can't.
Isabella?
The fog of unconsciousness immediately lifts from my mind. The moment I recognize the voice and my eyes snap open. There, looking down at me, is Rose? Oh, damn! Wait a minute! What the hell? So the ghost can mimic other voices. There we go. Crap. Another woman loiters beside her, but my attention is too focused on my co-agent to even ask why there's someone else with her. Rose's posture just screams worry, although she's keeping a straight face, or trying, at least. I can't help but feel bad for making her fret. A wave of dizziness washes over me as soon as I try to get up, forcing me to lie back down. Luckily, it subsides after a few seconds, until only a mild throbbing somewhere in the back of my head remains. With little assistance from Rose, I push myself up. She hands me an ice pack and gestures for me to press it where I suspect a small bump has already formed. The light ache in the area is an indication.
All right, Isabella, where are we?
Oh, check my journal. Oh, you're right. Okay, hang on. Give me one sec. One sec. Just gotta blow my nose. Let's take a look. Oh, jeez. Gotta be careful of that elbow. It says new timeline profiles. We have the note. So we have proof of something really creepy and shady going on right now. Uh, 26 years old. This is really weird. Sorry. October 17th and 18th, we have no journals, but for the 21st, we do. Did we go back in time? Weird. While looking for her missing co-agent, Isabella Santos found a mysterious letter in the Emigre Mansion's attic. Driven to fear by what she read inside, thinking it's the place's curse at work, she hurried to leave the place, only to meet Okay, I can't do anything with that.
The Ermengarde Mansion. Why? Ow, my head.
And the date today?
October 21st? Rose.
Last one. Can you count to 15 in reverse order?
15, 14, 13, No, that's wrong.
That's not good.
Why are we doing this?
She's just checking to see if your injury is in any way serious.
This time, I curiously regard the woman standing beside Rose. It's impossible to overlook her with what with the way she towers over us. And here I thought Rose is already tall. Who is she, anyway? One of the remaining cleaning crews? Yeah, I doubt it, with what she's wearing? Nope. But with how primly dressed she is, there we go. I don't think anyone would want to clean in a suit, an expensive suit at that. The gloves alone must have already cost a fortune. Her eyes slowly shift between me and Rose, considering us with an almost unreadable expression, before finally fixing a sharp gaze on me. I can't help but fold my arms protectively over myself as she does so. She may be far from a cleaning crew, but she certainly looks like my superior supervisor during evaluation days.
Just do it, please.
She's probably the owner, who's really pissed off that her realtor, had an accident. I eye them both warily, but recite everything she has asked. Rose releases a breath of relief once undone.
You scared me for a moment there. I was about to call for an ambulance when you started stirring. Are you all right?
Well, here's the thing. We have the note, and if the ghost doesn't have, a way to delete the phone calls, we have calls to Rose every single time. What would be scary is every time we called Rose, if Rose answered normally, not hearing us at all. Exasperation soon replaces the dull ache. The memory's a little fuzzy, but the attic and...
There was someone, Rose. In the attic.
Someone? You mean a client? Oh, that's unlikely. It's probably just one of the cleaning crews. The boss sent a few of them back this morning for some last minute...
No, not any of those. They're... I'm not actually sure.
It's a dead body. Maybe a ghost.
Wait, didn't I call you? You said you were in the attic when you answered. That's why I went there in the first place.
Both Rose and the lady look at me like I've just grown another head. Did I say something weird? Rose casts an apologetic smile at the woman beside her before the awkward silence stretches on further. Okay, guys, fill me in. I got a concussion here. Little help. It's her saleswoman's smile, the same one she taught me back when I was still her trainee. I should show this to troublesome clients or just to avoid trouble in general, she advised. Okay. It's also the one she gives me when I've done something particularly absurd that may cause us to lose a potential sale. Her eyes are serious when she turns back to me. She takes both my shoulders, gently squeezes it, and with as much patience as she can muster...
As much as I'd love to have gotten at least a heads up of your arrival, I didn't really get a call from you.
Okay, so we check the call listing and be like, is it there? Is it not? Okay, we got a problem.
You know, signal here is absolutely horrendous. I was in the garden earlier and couldn't even make a single call. Isabella, I'm going to ask again. Are you really all right? What happened?
Well, I went up in the attic. I saw something there. Got a note. Here's the note that I found. Even if what was there is not real, you got a creepy stalker guy here.
I don't know. It's all a bit blurry. I remember I was looking for you, but you weren't in the attic. And there's... whoever it is. Then I must have tripped on a rug or something on the way down.
Ghost Universal Mansion?
Oh.
Maybe.
Oh,
maybe.
No. Do you think someone came in while you were out? You left the main door open. We are so going to get into big trouble if something gets stolen, Rose.
Perhaps it is a concussion.
Okay,
Are you sure you feel fine? We could still call for an ambulance. I could cover for you.
No, that was the intro.
No, I'm fine. I'm okay, Rose. I can work.
Wait. Hold your horses, Rose. I can't just miss an important sale because of a minor bump in the head. An extremely minor bump. I've had worse when I was a kid. This is
nothing. Besides, if I leave, you'll have to shoulder everything in the open house. Alone. And in a mansion this big?
Well, there's also the part where I may lose that bonus BRC promised, but that's completely beside the point. Rose gives me a skeptical look when I return the cold compress to her and push myself off the floor. I have to use the staircase railings to steady myself, but otherwise I feel fine.
See? I'm A-okay.
Hey. What, as like a romance option? Kind of, the right. I did girls with green eyes. The two of them exchange a worried glance, and Rose assumes a contemplative look. I bite my lower lip in anticipation. If she says no...
Why are you in?
A smile threatens to slip out from me.
If I see that you aren't feeling well, I'm taking you personally to the nearest clinic to have you checked. Clear?
Clear. But really, I don't know why we're not showing the letter or checking the phone for call listings. Any of those would have been, you know, helpful.
Clear as day, ma'am. Thanks, Rose.
At least, okay, even if the woman to my left is the client, right? Somehow, we never met the client. I'm not too sure why we haven't met the client, if you think about it. Or the owner, I should say. we should at least pull Rose to the side and be like, yeah, this is the note that I found. There's really creepy things going on right now.
You insisted. But remember what I said. First sign of you looking not
Midnight.
Okay.
How you doing?
And we're off. No
Vigi
questions
games.
Asked.
I know, Vigi games.
It's just a small bump. Don't worry.
You shouldn't downplay these kinds of things. It could be a serious injury for all we know.
Suddenly, a small cough sounds against the walls of the foyer, interrupting our banter. The woman is looking expectantly at the two of us, her stare making me shrink back a little myself. She isn't really intimidating, but damn those gloves. Well, she is. But not in the scary, negative way, more in the like, I'm gonna beat you violently without money. Far from it, actually, her demeanor simply commands an air of sophistication and respect. In a different world, a younger me would have probably wished to be like her. She coughs again, lifting a well-trimmed eyebrow at me in question. Words get caught on my tongue, and Rose, as usual, is swift to catch my own blunders.
My sincerest apologies, Mrs.
Miss. Miss McCullough. Marianne McCullough.
Wait! You got a little phlegm in there, darling. What's up? What is with the phlegm? She hands Rose her business card. Interior designer. Ah, okay. It's Irish. Does the phlegm come with the Irish? Because I know a few Irish people. I mean, I'm partial Irish myself, but like, I've never heard anyone with the phlegm before. Maybe that's me. Oh, that's why. Okay, thank you, Super, because I'm like, wow, there's a... She's got to clear that throat. The words interior designer catch my eyes before my partner flips it over. Oh, probably someone interested in the mansion for its 17th century influences then. I won't hold it against her, though. Despite the hearsays and remaining uninhabited for years, the mansion's original fittings and furniture have been kept completely intact and restored to pristine condition. I suppose some people find that trip to the past feeling appealing. After all, with what it offers, this place is a definite haven for people looking to live somewhere with a classic historical charm.
Miss McCullough, I'm Rose Cooper, and this is my partner, Isabella Santos.
See, that sounded fine.
We're just ironing out a few things, but we'll be starting the tour soon enough.
Miss McCullough. Not McCullough.
In the meantime, we've prepared some refreshments for you in the parlor while you're waiting. If you could please.
Thanks. There's no need for it, though. I just dropped by for a quick survey of the place.
You know, I'm gonna say this, and I might be wrong, but the feeling I have is, instead of having a studio where these voice actresses came to do their the VO work, they might have done this online where they had each actor have their own setup, because this sounds like she has a little, like, the vocal absorption rate was not that good, because it sounds like there's a little bit of an echo.
I thought I should check the estate before I meet with the homeowners.
The confused look on Rose's face is impossible to miss when she glances at me. I return with an equally perplexed look. And against my better judgment, I blurt out the first question that comes to mind.
I'm sorry. Homeowners?
I should have kept my mouth shut. There's a look. A flash of irritation crosses her face, but it instantly disappears under a mask of professional detachment.
Yes. Hannah Wright? I was hired by her to handle the interior design for their newly bought home. This is the Ermengarde Mansion, right?
It is, but...
She pauses, possibly trying to find the right words to fix the awkward situation without offending someone. Oh, well, I mean, She's trying to be polite. Oh, my turn. Yeah, it doesn't sound like the same mic quality. Rose nudges me with her elbow. We'll check with our supervisor. Yep. There we go. Those few moments have given me enough time to clear my head of any nervousness or confusion clouding it.
It is, ma'am, but we weren't aware the mansion has already been sold.
Okay, so relationship. Oh, wow, there are bars. Luke, Ash, and Rebecca, Marine, Zachary, Hannah, and Isabella. Huh.
What do you mean?
Chubby, welcome to stream. Hope you're having a good day. I almost flinch when she turns her gaze on me, but I stand my ground. Besides, it isn't like I haven't dealt with awkward situations like this before. I don't know. I assume relationship is just where you stand as a friend. Again, first time with the visual novel, I have no idea what are the standard tropes for these games. Like, what are the go-tos? Jamie, welcome back, buddy. It does look like you can be other characters, though, maybe. Different perspectives when somebody dies? Maybe? I may screw up at times, but that doesn't mean I haven't learned a thing or two in the 5 years I've worked in the business.
The mansion is indeed for sale, ma'am. Today's the open house, in fact. However, we haven't heard anything from the higher-ups that a deal has already been closed for this particular property.
There isn't one for Rose. Wait. Huh. Most visual novels thrive on romance? Really? Willow, I think so. But to be fair, I don't really know. I know it's a horror game. That's about it.
If you'd like, my co-agent and me can check with them right now.
She nods, seemingly in deep thought after I finished. She appears to be a reasonable person anyway. Given the proper explanation, she'll likely understand.
I thought something looked odd when I arrived here. Excuse me, I think I need to make a call to my secretary.
Oh, see, Jamie, I haven't played the free-to-play game that he recently came out with, so...
Thank you for your assistance, Miss Santos.
With a slight wave of her hand, she leaves us, presumably to double-check with someone on her side. That seems to be the end of it. Both Rose and I breathe a sigh of relief. Disaster averted. I also don't miss the thumbs up she gives me for doing a good job. And I can't help but swell with pride. Still, I've already prepared myself to dial the number to our Luxborn office and check, even if she didn't ask for it. I would be very frustrated if, for some reason, an agreement has already been decided without my or Rose's knowledge. That's a whole new level of unfair. We've been working hard on this. Moments later, Miss Collin returns, looking a little frustrated, but an apology clear in her face. I feel a little sorry for her having to go through all this trouble.
There seems to have been a little misunderstanding with my client. If you'll allow it, I'd like to stay and wait for them here.
That was more like a, Minda. Well, it's more romantic than a kiss under the waterfall of blood. Oh, I mean, you know, honestly, where there is love, there is a way, even if it's a waterfall of blood.
I was informed they'll be dropping by for the open house today. I figured it'd be a waste to just leave after that long drive.
Okay.
I might as well meet him here.
Jamie, you're Irish, right? So, question for your brother. She says McCulloch with a phlegm-ish thing going on. Is that normal? Because, I said that she's kind of mispronouncing it wrong, so I'm just kind of curious here.
Certainly. You could stay at the parlor in the meantime, ma'am. I'm sure it won't be long before our guests arrive. And, Isabella? I left a few documents in my car. You know where I keep those.
That's normal? Phlegm? Really? Wow. I feel like she needs to go...
Can you please get it for me?
Rose takes a glance at her wristwatch before tossing me a set of keys.
And hurry! We've still got a few minutes to double-check those papers.
Okay, got it. Give me a few minutes.
The two then disappear behind the parlor's door. The departure brings with a hushed stillness to keep me company. Neither comforting nor soothing. This alone, it's impossible not to think of what truly happened earlier. And it's weird she's not talking about it. I get that she's trying to make a deal, but it's the interior designer, right? Fudge her. Like, we just had an ordeal. I wish the memory isn't as elusive as it normally is. Oh, so it's fuzzy. Okay. Then again, Rose already said she didn't receive any call from me. Again, check the call listing on your cell phone and the letter, whatever. Was it just my paranoia at work? A temporary lapse of my own mind after having heard all those tales about this place? Probably. I want to think of it as such. Better to think of it as such so I can work in peace. Except a small part of my mind begs to differ. And if I'm going to be completely honest with myself, I want nothing more than to leave this place as soon as possible. I don't know what's in this house, and I don't want to know. The keys Rose have just handed me dig into my palm. Its jagged edges creating shallow ridges on my skin from how hard I'm clutching it. It's a cursory reminder of what I still need to do and why I've taken this job in the first place. Hugging my blazer closer to my body, I exit the house to get what Rose has asked of me. Just a few more hours, Isabella. Sell the house, get the money, or see blood! Oh no! Journal update. Yeah, it's just like random updates. So just like a reminder, I guess. A flock of people have already gathered in the mansion's front yard by the time we officially open the doors. Chubby, let's just be honest. That's normal, right? You know, old house, sporadic amounts of blood, right? Sporadic, totally normal. If you want to sell it, you gotta fake it till you make it. I'm not sure whether I should feel baffled or underdressed standing in their presence. Men and women of wealth and status, all dressed to the nines in fancy suits and lovely dresses of varying colors, compose the medium-sized crowd. Their necks, arms, and fingers are adorned with silver and gold, glinting in the afternoon sun. Some even have ridiculously fancy feathered hats on their heads. Feathers. It's in. I really hope there aren't any magpies living nearby, like in the stories. Those birds will have a field day in this. Magpies? I don't know what that is, but if they're talking about birds, okay. They are murmuring among themselves, looking at the estate's facade praisingly, with some arguing about whose mansion is the superior architecture. Most of it stops as Rose calls for their attention. They don't look too pleased at being ordered around, but what can they do about it?
Ladies and gentlemen,
okay,
I'm Rose Cooper, okay. And this is my partner, Isabella Santos.
Of the Crowfitted camera. Oh, it's a crow family, okay.
We'll be taking a tour of the mansion in two groups. Please make sure you filled up our sign-in forms before joining a specific group.
Those who want to look around the first floor, please follow my partner. I'll be guiding the ones who wish to see the ground floor.
You know, I know Isabella's memory of the whole, like, creepy, violent thing going on that just happened, like, I don't know, 20 minutes prior. Really cliche? And I'm wondering if they're really gonna, are they gonna lean hard on the horror tropes that we know and love? Hearing this, a few wander towards me. They're mostly old ladies who seem daunted at the idea of climbing all those stairs. Hey, if you want fancy, you gotta work for it. Miss Collett also joins our group, but what really catches my eye is the elegantly dressed pair she approaches.
It's so nice to finally meet you! When Chief Inspector Lee mentioned that a famous interior designer is in town, I knew I had to get you!
Your confidence in my skills is very flattering, ma'am.
Oh, they're quite nice? Okay.
I'm sure you won't disappoint, Marianne.
Okay, he just sounds creepy and stalkery, right? Like, how are you today, ladies? I would love you with just a little hint of wine, yes.
Oh, you know each other?
Not at all, ma'am.
You mentioned something about a Marianne on our way here, darling?
Oh, yes, I think I did.
Yeah, sure, Bet. Essie, could you give Bet a quick permit? Pretty, please. They must be the clients she was talking about. I've seen their faces somewhere before. Some magazine or the television? I can't quite remember. But then again, most of our guests have likely ended up on the news. One way or another, I won't be surprised if these two have... Yeah. So, Bad, if you ever do a link from Google, make sure you click on the link itself, go to the webpage, and then go from there, because Google will tack on a slew of extra coding there. For people who are popular, though, they aren't dressed as loudly as the others, and in their simplicity, the couple stands out. The woman, in particular, is stunning enough to turn the heads of most of the people in my group, especially the men with wandering eyes. The guy standing beside her doesn't seem to mind, though. And if I'm going to be a bit bolder with my assumptions, I'll say he's basking in the attention. He's like, yeah, it's my wife. Mm. And good woman. Feel jealous. Both of them, in fact, peas in a pod. I'll think they are brother and sister if it isn't for their public display of affection. Ah, oh, we're going there, aren't we? Okay. The matching rings on their fingers just cement the fact that they are indeed a couple. Still could be siblings. I mean, it kind of is a thing depending on the royalty and the nobility, and yeah. Whatever. Couple or not, what's important is we get this deal closed before the current owners can even think of canceling the listing agreement. I just hope one of the people in my or Rosa's group is brave and generous enough to buy this mansion. And so, with papers in hand, I lead the way. Public displays of affection? I mean, it's not illegal, you know, in the US. It's frowned upon in school, though. When they aren't whispering among themselves or going ooh and ah over one thing or another, they ask questions. From how the restoration process went to the history of the place, I answer them all. More than happy to talk about the art pieces and architecture, mostly. However, I'm careful not to mention anything about the urban legend. People died here. Let's not decrease that property value, guys. Not a good material for sales talk, even if the entire population of Luxborn knows about it. Yeah, but you're lying to the people. So, one, they're gonna be miffed when they buy it. Like, wait a minute. People have died in this house. People have gone missing in this house, and you didn't let me get a better deal. Shame on you.
Some of the furnishings here are actually the 17th century originals, all of which have undergone a painstaking restoration process just to return its original beauty.
I hate to say this. Here's what's probably gonna happen. That nice couple that look like they're siblings, probably gonna buy the house, realize it's haunted, ask Isabella and Rose to show up, and then they're probably gonna get, like, a ghost squad showing up, right? And then Isabella's gonna die because she failed to mention the urban legend. Possibly.
Even the glass thing. Colorful ones. Oh, I don't know, but you get the idea, I hope.
Never mind.
Especially that one, ma'am. It is said to be a gift commissioned by the fiancé of Lady Charlotte Ermengarde. The mansion's current owners have specifically requested that the restoration crew take great care in handling it. It's a priceless work of art and the most distinctive feature of the mansion.
By the time I've stopped talking, her attention's already elsewhere. Very flighty.
Isn't this place wonderful, darling? I told you it's not a total waste of your time.
Bad, it's called Thundercavs. And it is impressive. Or get this... Yeah, she could get sued. Her and her, realtor, company, right?
I don't know. Isn't it a bit too small? We might have to break a wall down to have more room.
Okay, that's how he's gonna be.
Well, I think it is just right. Don't you think so, Marianne?
It is splendid, ma'am. But isn't it a little too early to make plans when no deal has been signed yet?
Never mind that. It isn't going to be a problem. We've got a wonderful legal team to handle everything. Start taking notes, though. I think I've got a few things I want changed before we move in.
Okay, I really hate to paint this couple as incestuous, possibly evil, but when she said we have a great legal team, I can only imagine if they want to go dark with this couple, like insidious, maybe they, like, I don't know, bait Isabella Rose back in and then piss off the ghost intentionally to see what happened. Just, you know, out of the joy that'll bring the couple, you know, and the fear it'll bring me. The rest of the conversation gets lost in the chatter of other companions. I don't want to think